that doesn't have to read what it reads. I can't go to jail.
Sit down. All right, that's fine. Sit down. No problem.
Sit down.
Here are three times when corrupt cops realize they've been caught. Starting with Midland County Sheriff Scott Stevenson, who was found unresponsive and slumped over the steering wheel on the side of the road on November 16, 2018. Kalkaska Sheriff's Deputy Ashley Van Sloten was dispatched to the location without any idea of what was going to happen next.
Sir. Sir? Pardon?
Excuse me, was going to cry this.
Pardon? Sir, you need to wake up and talk to me. I don't understand. What are you doing? You're on the side of the road, slumped over. What's going on? What's that? I need to know you're all right. Right now, you don't look all right. What's your name?
Not seeing much response, Officer Ashley decides to go back to her car and calls emergency services, worried for the well-being of Stevenson.
What's going on today?
Oh, jeez.
Holy shit.
What do
you have me light up for?
I have you lighted up because we had a call. Well, first off, it's so no one hits us.
Yeah.
And second of all, someone called, said you were sitting on the side of the road, slumped over, which you were.
Yeah. All right.
What's going on today?
Nothing?
You gotta give me a little more than that. Not just, we don't all just sit down and sleep on the side of the road.
I know, I'm sorry.
Have you been drinking?
Yeah?
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah, bad.
Okay.
Bad, I'm not driving.
Right, but you, how did you get here is the question.
Yeah, I know, Bad dealio.
Where are you coming from?
Midland? I'm from Midland.
Stevenson is first seen completely unresponsive, and what's interesting, it's that he immediately confesses to drinking once asked, something pretty unusual in these types of situations. Then, Stevenson's behavior changes entirely as soon as EMS arrives on the scene.
Listen, no, I don't know.
Van Sloten, hey, listen.
I don't know who you are.
I'm Midland County Sheriff. I'm good. I had a bad day. Okay. I don't need EMS. I don't need you. It'd be cool if we. What you know? But I don't. I do not need EMS. Where are you?
Kalkaska. This is Kalkaska County. He's all right.
We're good.
Step out. Yeah. Step out. Talk to them. We're going to need to know you're all right because they already have been called. You know the drill.
Once emergency services arrive, it appears as if Stevenson realized that he could be even more compromised if, for example, a breathalyzer test was done on him. Then, as Kalkaska County Sheriff Jerry Cannon arrives on the scene, Van Sloten has Stevenson perform several sobriety tests, which Stevenson fails miserably at.
1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, can't really do, you know.
Mm-hmm.
9.
You're on a slant here.
Okay, ready?
Ready. Ready when you are.
You sure?
Yeah.
I don't know if I want to do right or left.
It's up to you. Whichever one's more comfortable for you.
Six, seven.
Officer Van Sloten then makes Stevenson take a breathalyzer test, and here is when things get heated.
Okay. Blow, 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 blow.
Is that good?
Might be.
Jesus. Oh, Jerry. Well, you know what? Hey. Hey, man. Jesus Christ, I'm praying. I know the situation I'm putting you in. Jerry.
Jesus Christ.
Give me a. Try to help me out, man. I can't go to jail for. Seriously.
Seeing the test has given 0.23, Sheriff Stevenson knows he's in big trouble, and he won't go down without a fight.
That doesn't have to read what it reads. Jesus Christ, Jerry. I'm I got my f***ing uncle that's going to goddamn nurse home. My f***ing mom's fucking the same f***ing way. I have nothing. My brother and I it's been a bad day, Jerry. Jesus Christ. Please help me, man. Please help me. Man, f***ing help me. I got enough shit on my plate right now. I don't f***ing need that. This is, you know how f***ing embarrassing this is? Do you know how embarrassing this is, Jerry?
I can imagine.
Jesus Christ. Give me a f***ing, I'm not gonna get into a goddamn accident or something. I'm not gonna hurt anybody. Jesus Christ. Please f***ing help me. Please.
I want to, but I mean.
Jesus Christ, Lancelot. You can. You can. Jerry, you. God damn, Jerry. Are you serious? I can't go to jail for drunk driving, man.
You created this situation.
Okay.
You know this. And it's a sandwich, and you're throwing it at her feet.
I'm not trying to throw it at her feet.
I know.
So
I understand you're upset. I know. You don't have to apologize to me.
I was pulled over on the f***ing road, man. I know. It's not like I hit somebody or it was...
I know.
I pulled over. I'm like, I gotta...
I know.
Jesus Christ.
I don't...
Man, Slocum, please f***ing help me out, man. Just f***ing please f***ing help me out. Jesus Christ. Jerry.
It's not my call. I mean, I'm...
It is your... Call
I'm a,
to a certain extent.
Well,
it is. Where's your f***ing sergeant? I mean, Jesus Christ, Jerry. Come on, man. I got chilly in the back of my goddamn car to go to your f***ing place, man. Jerry, this is not the end of the world, man. I was f***ing pulled over. I was already over. I wasn't f***ing knocking anybody off the road. I was f***ing here, Jerry. Jesus Christ, I was here. I'm going up to your place. Just please don't.
That's you put me in a spot where I'm...
I understand.
You know what I mean?
Understand.
You put me in a spot that I have no... I have control over,
you
but
do.
You know that morally, I can't just let you go.
You don't, then. Then get a hook and take my car, and I'll go with the hook. And whatever, be there for 8 hours or whatever. I don't give a, but you can't take me, man. Don't f***ing do that. I'm a sheriff, man.
Stevenson's behavior with Van Sloten in Sheriff Cannon's absence is enraging, and not only has she been giving him ample time and consideration, more so than they would do with a normal citizen, but he continues to ask and beg the officer for her not to take him to jail, which if she were to do, she'd be fired once the truth is revealed. Then, shockingly, as the sheriff explains what's going to happen, he says, it's not like the old days, once again reinforcing how important body cams are for these situations.
Yep.
Gotta go. Mm-hmm. I'll take responsibility for this, so you don't have to tow or...
Okay. I'm so sorry.
I don't know
I am.
What that means.
Christ. Oh, you got to kick in.
Oh, Jesus Christ, you're right.
Everybody, I mean, it's on the radio. It's,
yeah.
They don't, it's just, the cat's out of the bag. And, it's, you know, it's not like the old days.
Jesus Christ, I can't go to jail for drunk driving. God damn it. Are you me? Can you not just, can I just not get this car towed and put me, I don't know, Jerry. Come on. Are you me?
I'm not. It's as serious as a heart attack, and you know
it. Jesus Christ, are you me? You gotta arrest me for drunk driving.
We've already been through this.
All right, Jerry.
Lock her up, give me the keys. It'll be at my house.
I'm so, my brother's gonna be. Oh, Jesus Christ. My life's taking a change. I am Jerry.
Stevenson was later brought down to the station, surprisingly, with all of his belongings on him and no cuffs. Fortunately, he was later booked on DUI charges. Stevenson was sentenced to just 1 year of probation as he pleaded guilty to being intoxicated. And if you're wondering, he didn't lose his job and continued being a sheriff until 2020. And we all know that whenever something happens, a supervisor is one of the first figures to be called on the scene. But what happens when it's the supervisor, the one who's committed a crime? On January 1st, 2021, Gainesville Corporal Scott Bertzik had been driving in Florida when he reached down for his lighter and crashed into a vehicle that had just started to move. Officer Brooke Shutterly responded to the scene immediately and noticed something off about her supervisor.
He reached down for my lighter, slammed into his ass.
Cool.
Yeah. Not really.
Yeah. He didn't want to do an information exchange?
No, he does. Now I found it.
Okay. Well. Okay.
You want to just information exchange? Now I found it.
Okay. Are you okay?
Oh, yeah, no, I'm good.
Your airbag went off. Your car s***ed up.
Oh, no, absolutely.
That sucks. Police Neil's off. You can come give your ride. Do you want me to let him know you found the insurance?
The same thing.
Well, maybe you should not do that then. So, you want me to let him know you found your insurance, see if he wants to do an information exchange?
Christ.
Officer Brooke immediately recognizes her supervisor, which it's clearly drunk and even laughs when thinking of the situation. As the officer approaches the victim, we can see their car, and we can safely say it's not lightly damaged.
So, he mentioned you guys had talked about exchanging information, but he hadn't had his insurance pulled up.
Yeah.
We have a couple options with this. It's really cut and dry, so if you want to just go through insurance, you can. If you want a full-fledged report, we can do that, however you want to go about it.
After explaining some insurance details to the victim, we can see some wrong things with the way Shutterly handles the victim that tells us she is taking the side of her supervisor instead of being neutral.
So a couple things. One, do you mind giving me like a couple feet? One, because I like personal space, and two, because cigarette smoke, it tears me up a little bit. Just, like I said, it'll probably take me about 15, 20 minutes, and then I'll get that done for you, okay? No, we don't take pictures of it, because crashes are civil. Yeah, whenever we do any kind of crash reports or anything, unless there's a DUI involved or, you know, like a hit and run or something, a criminal aspect, we don't usually take photos. Thank you. You know I don't need that. Should hypothetically auto-populate. Give me a second, because I'm going to call Priester and see if he needs me to do anything special, since it's one of us.
Yep.
So.
Yep.
Give me a minute. Sorry, Birdie.
Referring to her supervisor by his nickname, Birdie, and saying she would try to see if she could help him out of the situation is only making matters worse. She also fails to inform the victim that he had been involved in a DUI accident without mentioning how she treated him in a completely different way as she did with her supervisor. Then, after she's dealt with the victim, things take a turn as she informs Bertzik that he is going to be detained.
So, Bertie, you giving me some indicators?
Oh.
Listen.
Shh, woman.
Listen. Valdez is coming out just to... I'm not going to lie to you about it.
She's on her way?
Yeah, she's on her way.
376-1087.
Because I'm not really comfortable with this whole thing at all. But I'm not going to lie to you about it.
Oh, no. I don't mean to put you in that any... Yep.
Yeah. So... From now on, you know how it goes. You can't consume anything, okay? Because right now, you're being detained.
Wait, what?
And this is when Bertie realized he wasn't going to get out of this situation as easily as he had thought.
I'm holding on to you because I have a supervisor coming to see if I need to do a full-fledged DUI investigation or not. So please don't make my life difficult.
I would never do that to you.
Okay. I'm very uncomfortable right now.
And I apologize for putting you in that position.
Okay.
After being notified and apologizing, it seems as if Bertzik still thinks he can get away with it until he realizes that everything's being recorded.
Are you on?
Yes. Yes, I am. And I'm going to remain on
for... Fair enough.
Because I... Integrity.
Not long after this, we can see how Bertzik goes through a period of realizations as he acknowledges he's in big trouble.
That person's life being up there.
I'm not
going to
say anything.
It's up there, I don't care.
I mean about this.
I'm not drunk, I'm pissed and I'm tired. Me. She did it, I don't give a. What the f***, man?
Bravo 23, you have all channels, 1014.
Whatever. Divorce, I don't know.
As a supervising officer arrives on scene, Bertzik is made to perform several sobriety tests, which we can say he doesn't perform really well.
You may begin the test.
Having failed the tests completely, Bertzik is told he will be arrested. While arresting Bertzik, Shutterly says she wouldn't cuff him, but he asks her to, as the victims had stayed to watch the officer get arrested as they waited for the tow company.
Take them around to your driver's side.
Yeah.
There you go.
Listen to me.
Come on.
I'm not going to help you.
Oh, yes, you are, because they're watching.
No.
Yes, you are. They're watching.
Okay. My car.
Yes, you will.
Yes. Yes.
Supervisor Bertzik was finally sentenced to fines totaling $974, 50 hours of community service, various substance abuse, DUI classes, and a 6-month driver's license suspension. He was also sued by the driver and passenger of the vehicle he struck, and a settlement was reached in that case. But not all drunk cops complied with the arresting officer, though, as this next one tried to flee the scene. East Cleveland SWAT detective Joe Marche had been found intoxicated and slumped over the wheel by Ohio police.
Said he's breathing.
Is he medical?
I don't know. He's breathing. See if the door's unlocked. All right, I can't tell if it's in gear or not. All right. Police! Open the window. Open the window. Sir, open the window.
Marsh had locked the doors and was unwilling to get out of the car. Then all of a sudden, he does something you wouldn't expect from a detective.
Open the window! Stop! Stop! Can't reach. Stop now. Here, open the door. I can't go get the switch yet.
No! No! No!
No!
No!
No!
No!
Police department, stop!
Put your hands up right now. Put your hands up!
When Marche was finally handcuffed, an officer found a loaded MP7 automatic weapon in his police bag, along with several items from his personal kit. Seeing this, and the fact he's absolutely out of his mind, he's taken to the station. Once there, Marche surprisingly has sobered up and realizes he's caught in a mess, but he won't go down without putting up a fight.
Officer Trusso, you can call me Vince, okay? I'm OIC tonight. All right? I'm gonna uncuff you. Joe, no problems, right? So, man to man.
Excuse me.
Listen to me, man, okay? I'll just stand up and I'll uncuff you, okay?
Contrary to what they would do to 99% of people, they uncuffed Joe as soon as he got to the station to later interrogate him further.
You're being arrested for the OVI. You put my partners in a bad position, okay?
Well, I shouldn't be arrested for anything.
Listen, well, you put them in a position. Then you start resisting.
I didn't resist anything.
Okay, listen.
I didn't resist anything.
All right, well, this is what we're doing. We're having some of your teammates are coming to pick the car up and everything. Joe.
Okay.
Listen, with due respect, sir. Listen to me. I'm going to give you respect.
All right.
Listen to
me.
Please
do.
You're wasted.
You sit down. Listen. Sit down. Sit down. Listen. Sit down, Joe.
Hey, Joe,
sit
that?
Down. I know.
That?
Sit down.
That should definitely not be happening. Everybody knows a weapon is dangerous. Now imagine a dangerous weapon in the hands of a drunk person. What's more shocking is not this, but how the officers didn't retrieve the gun from him before.
I can't drive around drunk and f***ing have my weapon on me. We shouldn't be able to do that, sir. On top of it, you have all your turnout gear, your kit in the back. And your fucking MP7 in the back.
I do.
Oh, come on. Sir?
I do.
I'm not trying, no disrespect at all. I respect
you. Well, you know
you.
What?
All right?
You
were passed out on my side street.
Roger.
All right? Listen, we got some of your teammates are coming down to pick up your vehicle. We're going to process you, and then they're going to come here and pick you up. I need to ask you, is that your service weapon, or is that an off-duty?
No, it's my service weapon.
Your service weapon? East Cleveland owns that?
Yep.
Okay. Hate to do this to you. I really do.
I'm not doing anything.
Oh, sit down. Sit down. All right, that's fine. Sit down. No problem.
You know.
Sit down.
You know.
Sit down, Joe. Sit down, please.
No.
Sit down. I do.
Doing.
I get it.
I'm not
but
doing
you put my teammates in a bad position.
How do I put your guys in a bad position?
You were passed out on the side of the street, sir.
Okay.
You were passed out over there. Listen. Go ahead. You can talk.
No, go ahead.
You were passed out on the side of the street. My partner had to freaking knock on the window several times. You put it in park and went to drive away. And I know for a fact the way you're handling yourself right now, if this was EC and someone did that to you, you'd be doing the same thing, sir.
You know what?
You know I'm right.
I'll tell you what.
You're starting to smirk because you know I'm right.
No, I'll tell you what. I probably would.
I know.
I probably would. But I would not jam up one of your guys.
What am I supposed to do?
You're jamming me up.
I'm not jamming you up.
Yes, you
I'm
are.
Processing you and having your teammates come and get you.
Jamming me up, bro.
I'm not.
You're jamming me
down.
Up.
Calm down.
You're jamming me up.
You put my guys in a bad position. You did.
Oh, man.
You did.
Come on,
you
man.
Did. You're not doing any of this?
No.
All right. I got to read you the form anyway, so just hold that. You read the receipt for me.
I got you.
Are you kidding me?
Nothing I can
serious?
Do about it. I got to do my job, man.
Let me tell you something. I'll tell you what. Do your job. But I'll tell you what. Come on the other side of the bridge. I'll do my job.
We're on the same team, bro.
Oh, Roger that.
Okay?
Exactly.
I got to look out for my teammates.
Absolutely.
I got to look out for my teammates. You understand
Absolutely.
Me, Joe?
Not only does the officer speak to him as if he was some type of mafia boss, but Detective Joe even dares threatening the officer, saying he'll do his job if he finds him in his jurisdiction.
One day.
You threaten me, dude.
No, I'm not
okay.
You.
I don't want to do this,
well,
man.
I'm threatening. Come on,
I don't
want
to.
Hopefully there's cameras.
Yes, there is cameras.
Oh, thank goodness.
All right?
I'm not threatening you at all.
Marcha had his driver's license suspended and only received a 30-day suspension without pay. But is that enough for a drunk cop who's armed? Let us know in the comments. If you enjoyed this video, watch this one, and don't forget to subscribe. Goodbye.